Okay, so I was 10 days in Denmark with 1,000 young leaders from all over the world, from 129 countries, to solve the most complex socio-economic issues that our world is facing. And now I just have 2.5 minutes to talk about those things. So I'm gonna use the opportunity to tell about our pitch, our idea. We formed a team of very talented guys, so five people, and we want to talk about migration. There are 250 million migrants around the world, and I'm one of them. I'm originally from Afghanistan. I've been privileged to come to the Netherlands and study here. I did a degree in economics and development economics from Tilburg University. And as an economist, I thought, what can I do? How can I make myself useful for my country of origin? So one day I took a car and drive all the way back to Afghanistan. And we built a school, a micro hydro plant. We were providing 300 families with electricity. We built a library, a lot of cool stuff. But at the same time, it seems like a drop in the ocean. How can you bring system change? And I've been researching this topic called brain drain. And we are from Brainport region, and we are very good at causing brain drain. But the brain drain does not necessarily have to be a very bad thing. People do migrate. That's been always there because of harsh political realities, because of economic hardship, but also, let's not forget, because of low quality of education in a lot of developing countries. Lots of you guys have got a scholarship, a PhD or a master who come to Eindhoven, and you study here, and we hope that you stay and work for our industry and stay here and integrate. But at the same time, we have also a moral responsibility to do something back home. I'm giving myself an example. I had a lot of trouble to finding institution who can support me in my endeavor to do something back home. So that's what we have been looking for to do. Migrants can become agents of change. As entrepreneurs, as social entrepreneurs, as activists, as ambassadors, but also as people who can build markets, right? So what's lacking, according to us, there are enabling channels who can facilitate this process, right? So we mean cooking ideas, how can we tackle these issues? But in the end, it's all about money, right? We lack the funds. Who is gonna pay for this process? Now, if you look at numbers, there's something called remittances, financial remittances. These 250 million migrants, expats, refugees, allochtone, whatever they call it, they collectively sent $610 billion a year back home to their families. And these are from 2015. But same time, so this $610 billion, this is 4 times as much as all the development aid together, okay? So these people are sending their money back home to their families, right? And one of the problem is that it's fragmented, people sending it individually. Another big problem is the cost of transfer. It costs approximately 8% to send money back home, right? In some countries, even 17-20%. Imagine how much money that is. If we can reduce that amount and allocate it to not only personal family matters, but to collective community improvement, like building a school. Right, so we have been looking, how can we create incentives? How can we facilitate this process? How can we bring disruption? And it is a very, very complicated matter, the banking system, the institutions, the incentives. So we've tried to, okay, how can we, keep it simple? Let's go on. So migration is coming, and we are talking about host country, which, let's start with Eindhoven. So I'm based in Eindhoven. And there are people who are established here, they settled, and they ask themselves, I want to do something back home. And what needs to happen is there's a lack of institution or organization who can facilitate this process, who can coordinate this. So we've been looking, one more thing. So aside the sending the money back home, that's very interesting. The money is always interesting, but also the ideas we learn and adopt here, bringing them back home, that has also a very important factor for development. So we're looking at how can we create a platform where migrants or expats who want to do something back home, how can they pool their resources, how they can learn from each other, and they can initiate projects back home, and they can also mobilize their own communities through hometown associations or migrant associations or their families and friends, but also their colleagues within Brainport region, within high-tech campus or within universities whatsoever. But of course, it's very conceptual, and we're working on, okay, well, who are the stakeholders? What incentives do we need? And who needs to take start with this? And I really believe that the universities have a starting point. So we would love to pitch this idea. So, okay, how can this fit within your curriculum as a university? Can you teach expats or graduates entrepreneurship? They can bring technology from Eindhoven Brainport to solve more complex environmental, social, economic problems in India, Bangladesh, Italy, wherever. So that's actually what I'm working for. If you have suggestions, ideas, I would love to hear from you. Thank you very much. That was a brief short. I hope I keep it a little time.